love talking dirty, but it would be awkward if I was in a relationship with someone who didn't like it. I think my passion is to enable people to have the best relationships that they can, not just with other people, but with themselves as well. Because if you have a great relationship with yourself, then it so improves your ability to have fantastic relationships with other people. There are lots of ways in which people might have drifted apart. It could be because of pressures of work, having children, maybe looking after elderly parents. But if you can make time for the couple so that you're doing something spontaneous or perhaps reconnecting with the things that you used to love doing when you first met, those can be really good ways of spicing up your life together. The one thing that negatively affects people's sex life is self-confidence. So much of what happens in the bedroom actually takes place in your head, and therefore, if you can be in the right mindset and you can feel fully confident about what you look like and your abilities, that is the one thing that's really going to help your sex life. Relationships. Well, the most common question that I'm asked is, how can I find love? And really, the only answer to that is you have to go out there and be love. You kind of have to be the change that you want to be. So if you're loving and if you show yourself love, then love will come to you. Diet affects sex drive enormously, not least because what we see in people with eating disorders is that it really plays havoc with their libido. You can eat very successfully to improve your sex life, to make you feel more vital, more alive, and also just to give yourself that extra vitality by eating lots of vegetables and fruit so that you know that everything you're eating is nutritious and you're loving your body at the same time. Some people really struggle to orgasm. And again, because sex kind of happens in your head as much as happening in the bedroom, you need to get yourself into a very relaxed state so that you feel very confident. But there are also other techniques in terms of having orgasmic orgasms. Some of it's to do with communication with your partner so that you can feel relaxed about asking them to do certain things. And some of it is also about knowing how you yourself can bring yourself to orgasm, and that's of course masturbation. So if you try and masturbate perhaps even once a day, you can really get in touch with what makes your body tick, and that can be a brilliant way of improving your ability to have orgasms.